Hey, this is Clint from Clint's Reptile Videos, and I apologize in advance because this video will not be up to our normal quality standards. The reason being, what we're about to share with you is something brand new, something I have seen nowhere else, something we just discovered for ourselves, and you're going to be the first to hear about it. And so we wanted to get this video out to you now, like right now, because this information is minutes old. I was just recently pointed in the direction of a new paper that was published in Current Biology last month. Current Biology is a journal. And it talks about the sex determination of ball pythons, specifically that they have XY sex determination, which is just like humans do, except they evolved it independently. Why this is so exciting is because it makes sense of a great mystery in ball python genetics, and that is this snake right here. This snake is a banana ball python. This snake is actually a banana pinstripe lesser ball python, but one of the genes that makes it the most yellow, is this banana gene, and the banana gene is super weird. This banana here is a male, and his father was a banana, and banana is inherited as an incomplete dominant trait. In the hobby, people will tell you it's codom or codominant, but technically it's really incomplete dominant, which means that if you have two copies of this banana gene, you're extra banana, more banana than one that only has one copy. And this may be over your heads a little bit for some of you, but for others who've really been wondering about this, this is gonna make sense of everything about banana. So the weird thing about bananas is that I've got a male banana here whose father was a banana. And almost all of his offspring that have this banana trait will be males. He will produce almost no female offspring that are bananas. A female banana, alternatively, can produce male and female banana offspring. And the son of a female banana will produce almost entirely female bananas. That has made almost no sense until now. Because previous to now, we thought that ball pythons had a ZZZW inheritance pattern for sex determination. They don't. They're XY, and that makes everything make sense. Because this is not exactly the same as our XY. In humans, for example, the Y chromosome codes for very little, and in ball pythons, that Y chromosome has to at least code for the gene that has this banana mutation on it, in addition to the X chromosome, which also has it. In the case that I've got what you call a male maker banana, which is what mine is, he has that mutation on his Y chromosome. In order for him to, for starters, he will pass that Y chromosome on to every single one of his sons. The only case in which the Y chromosome, the only case in which he would have a daughter with the banana mutation is if a crossing over event occurred between the X and the Y chromosome, then he could produce a daughter with that banana mutation. A female would have it on her X chromosome, and she could pass that X chromosome onto her sons and her daughters, so it makes perfect sense that she can produce both male and female banana offspring. A male banana that had a mother that was a banana would have the mutation on his X chromosome, which he would pass on only to his daughters. The only case in which he would have a son with the banana mutation is if a crossing over event happened between the X and the Y, and the X now picked it up. That makes sense of the world. Banana is on the X and Y chromosomes, and now male maker and female maker bananas makes sense. I'm excited that I got to share this with you guys first. More to come on this, more to come on ball pythons for sure. As always, like and subscribe. Let us know what you thought, and we hope to see you real soon.